Let's see how a common respiratory tract infection with virus that we face every day will be controlled. So it is not just steam inhalation. I would correctly say it's a triple heat therapy. It involves steam inhalation, wash the face with warm water, as well as gargling the throat with warm water. So let's see first how we do effectively the steam inhalation. So for that, you need to have 2 to 3 liters, that is kettle full of water, boiling water, and a container to pour it, and a blanket to cover the steam. So you need to understand, we have 2 nostrils. So we will be breathing steam through 1 nostril at a time, and you should be changing over the time. So sometimes you may notice the 1 nostril is blocked than the other, where the infection is going on. So you need to do the steam inhalation for a longer time on that side. So you have to take very slow inhalations and take about 5 seconds. If I imitate that. And you have to exhale through the mouth and do this repeat over again. If you have a cough, you can still do the technique I explained to you, as well as you can just inhale and exhale just through the mouth to get most of the heat to the your lower respiratory tract. And after that, you have to do the about 3 to 5 minutes hot water face wash, as well as followed by gargling of hot water or this really warm water in your throat. So let's see what's the science behind this one. As soon as you do this triple heat therapy, you get immediate relief within 5 to 10 minutes. That is due to the blockage relief with the steam, as well as the control of the pain for a little bit. But this is not due to the control of the virus. The real effect comes with this heat, your blood gets local blood vessel gets dilated, little an extra blood flow coming with extra army of white blood cells, and that will eat up all the infected respiratory cells into the virus. So that's how it controls at the early stages. In medical terms, we call it cell-mediated immunity. And when you continue to do this steam inhalation for about 24 to 48 hours, the second mechanism comes into work. So where your lymphocytes produce antibodies against this virus, that is the definite treatment for this virus in your body. So it will destroy the virus, as well as it will never let this virus to infect your body again. So that is we call humoral immunity. So this is roughly the science behind this steam inhalation. And we'll see when to do this. Timing is very important. So you have to do the steam inhalation at very early stages. You can't wait for 24 hours to do this once you get the symptoms. So this is how we do it. You may be really well today, but tomorrow we might feel a bit unwell. That can be the only reason that you're going to get a cold. So that's where you have to act. Or you may be having nasal runny noses, or you may be having a nasal congestion, or you may have a little change in the voice, or headache, or sore throat, or the pain in your upper palate, or maybe some excessive amount of phlegm coming to your throat, or body aches like joint pains, muscle pains and aches, as well as fever and cough. Just start then and there to get the best effect. And then how frequently you have to do it. So you need to be doing this one at least 2 to 4 times a day, depending on the infection. And what are the things that you shouldn't be doing during this heat treatment? The most important thing is you should be avoiding cold drinks and cold food all the time, and cold water and exposure to cold weather, like if you're in winter time or in a really cold air conditioner. And also, you shouldn't be taking paracetamol or other painkillers unless you have fever or really severe body aches at the early stages of illness. There are two reasons. One, these painkillers won't control your virus infection at all. And otherwise, all our success or the improvement in the treatment depend on improvement of our symptoms. So if you take paracetamol and if you undermine your symptoms, you don't know where you are. And also, you shouldn't be doing the steam inhalation if you have fever. So you have to take paracetamol and bring your fever down, and then about an hour or so, you need to be doing the steam and the triple heat therapy. And another most important thing is you shouldn't be sharing any of this equipment you use to do the steam inhalation or any other steam therapy. And you should be washing your hands really well afterwards. So when to stop this? Usually, just once the symptoms are improved, or usually 24 to 48 hours once everything is resolved. So that's the technique, basically, how to control, perform the triple heat therapy. And one more thing that I just forgot to say, if you take paracetamol to control your fever or the severe body aches, you have to follow the triple heat therapy every time you take paracetamol. So because the paracetamol undermine your symptoms, you don't know your virus is growing, so only thing you can do it, just repeat after every time you take medication. Having said that, all these techniques, there are situations where you have to be very precautious. One is if you are immunocompromised, or if you're taking any medications to bring your immune system down, you need to take medical advice before you're doing anything. And the other thing is, if you don't have improvement within 48 hours of the steam inhalation without taking Panadol, you have to stop this and seek medical attention, because some other infections, non-viral infections, for example, throat infection with a bacterium, will give you some of the symptoms of common respiratory tract infection like sore throat, but it won't affect it can't be treated by steam inhalation. You have to take antibiotics for that. And also, these days, we are having this new coronavirus infection spreading, so you shouldn't be taking any risk with that. Always wash your hands, cover your sneeze and your cough, as well as use the mask if necessary. And also, if you have come across a patient, or if you've been in a place that patient was there, please take medical advice at the first place before starting any of this heat treatment. And then once you manage properly with all these doctors, there's no harm for doing this one for anyone. And to be honest, I'll be doing this triple heat treatment therapy for about 20 years for myself, and also I'm advising to my other patients and friends to do this. And on my aspect, I never had a common respiratory tract infection going below my throat. I'm always controlling it within 48 hours, and I never had situations where I have to take antibiotics or suffering for long-term cough, this as a complication of respiratory tract infection. So I never been away from work because of any respiratory tract infection or related complications. I never taken Panadol for respiratory tract infection unless to control fever to get going with the triple heat therapy. So guys, if you think this information is useful, please do it for yourself. And if you feel better, next time when you get early symptoms of your respiratory tract infection, just share with others and teach to others, and it will save lots of time, money, more than everything, your good health. And also, thank you so much for listening for this talk for about 10 minutes now. And I wish you all the best for everyone, and also not to come across this new coronavirus infection, and also in the future have a very good better control within 48 hours with all the common respiratory tract infections. Thank you guys. Bye.